Welcome to Thinker Metrics, demystifying the world of analytics, one graph at a time. From e-commerce metrics to app performance and the latest social media trends, we have your metrics that matter covered. The best part, you don't need to be a data pro. This is for everyone. Whether you're a UX wizard or just curious about the digital world, we make analytics fun and accessible. So grab your data about the companies you care about and fire up Excel or Tableau and join us as we make sense of the numbers together. Subscribe and join our Thinker Metrics community today. Here we go, yo. What's the scenario? And the scenario today is we are working with deal room data, which allows us to download startup data and graph that in Tableau. So if you are exploring what companies are in the area of interest you have, if you're in that strategic mode where you're like, who plays in this industry? I want to do a competitive analysis. I want to see where there are gaps that I could play strategically and win as a startup. And what other areas that do they work at as far as like business models? Are they subscription and things like that? So we're going to focus on direct to consumer. So consumer businesses, that D2C type of company. So instead of the retailers like an REI that gets all the coolest brands in the outdoor industry and their buyers are amazing at curating the selection of those like Roan and many others. And instead, we can look at those actual brands and how they connect with you. So sometimes they now have all these cool food startups and cosmetics and everything else where they have their own sites, their own social media platforms, and they own that relationship with you where they can reach out to you by email, text message, WhatsApp, or whatever, and post on their Insta stories, and they know who you are. So that's a little bit different of a business model than trying to get in those stores and working with those buyers and lobbying them to put you on the shelf in a good space on the end cap and everything else like that. So we will focus on direct to consumer because it's a little bit more fun with digital marketing because they have a lot of that visibility using all of this amazing data from Meta and Facebook and Google Analytics and ads and everything. And that is why I want to focus there because it's a little bit fun from a digital perspective since we have that visibility. So let's do that. Go to Deal Room, sign up for an account. You can do a free account without having to put in a credit card. So you will create the account and you'll also click start premium trial and you get 7 days. It looks like I have 6 days left since I just started it right up there. And so you will go into that and then search for these companies and use the advanced filters there. And I chose consumer focus as well as subscription just for fun. You can choose whatever you want to narrow it down because you're going to want to narrow it down because it has 5 million companies. We want to narrow it down. We're only going to get to download 25 twice. So be very careful when you do this. You get 25 rows to download in this export. Super nice of them. It's almost impossible in many companies to get a free trial in these sort of enterprise products where you have to talk to a salesperson or something like that and pay $60,000 for a huge enterprise license in some cases. And it's great that they actually let you download a file, play around with it, and get a feel for how it really works. So props to them for that. And if you can and will, please subscribe to whatever they have when you're in the position to do so. So awesome there. I'm going to click travel. So I know, long story short, just wanted to throw that out there. Travel, consumer, and subscription. And here's the list. So you can run that and then click save and export. So travel, consumer. If you want to save that, you can just export it, I guess. So whatever. We're going to click just export. I only have 25 rows left. This is the most important spot. You pick what columns of data that you want to pull in. It has some here with the revenue model and the growth stage, which is super important. If you're looking at where that company is in that life cycle of a startup, is it just starting an early stage? Is it well on its way to growth and scale and beyond to a giant company? So those are super important as you figure out how to compete and what the opportunity is. You can also see the number of employees and some other things that are interesting. So website traffic, app downloads. I think it lets you do as many of these as you want. And some of them have null values in it. You know, data quality isn't perfect. So I'm going to go ahead and click as many of those that might make sense. Got app rank. You have the website traffic estimate of the yearly growth. You have some rank there as well. Valuation, both dollars and euros probably, and the date of the valuations. You can see if that's out of date or not, because if it's not a public company, it might be quite out of date. EBITDA, if you're in the financial analysis or accounting of companies, that's the earnings before income tax, taxes and depreciation. The profit as well. So yeah, sure, throw a few of those on there. I'm just gonna grab a couple of the other things. Twitter favorites, Twitter followers values, Facebook likes, Twitter number of tweets, and see what else we got. Employee latest, maybe that's the latest number of pens. I don't know if they'll have all of these, but we may as well try to figure out what we can get here. And it lets you choose a export as a CSV or an Excel file. Doesn't matter. We can bring either one into Tableau or Excel. Either one can do that. Great. The comma separator file is the most simple without any other formatting. So I'm going to go with that and click export and get my last 25 rows that I can get on this free trial from Deal Room, and we'll pull right in. So building the file, and now it is ready to download. Got that. Names it terribly. So we're going to call this travel subscription, and these are worldwide startups, so we're going to see something from all over the place. You can call it startups, you can call it deal room, whatever you want. Hit enter there. It's a very small file because that's 25 rows. That's not a lot of data, and we're going to pop right into Tableau and make some graphs. All right, coming up hot on Tableau, we got that in book one. And what we're going to do is, instead of connecting to Excel, since it was a CSV, we're going to go to more and connect to that CSV travel subscription. Startups is what I call it. So double click that. Pull it right in. So you can see in the data source tab what it pulled in here and if it got any everything right. I'm gonna go ahead and make that a little bigger and then pop over to the sheet and see it from here. So some of these won't be great. Those were measures on a revenue and income and app rank, but didn't quite figure those out. So we'll have to see what's in the data and see if those are useful or not. Like I said, there's going to be a lot of null data. Not every company is going to have all sorts of data. So the name of the company is the most important thing. So we pull that in here and you can see what it pulled. So we got Atlas Obscura, amazing site, really fun on little unique travel type things. They also do events in person sometimes, or at least they did before COVID. And I definitely went to the Seattle Grunge Era tour on that one. It was quite a bit of fun. Cool. So we have some others from all over, it looks like. Resvi, which is a well-known startup as well. And what could we pull in? So I'm gonna pull in everything really quick. So maybe that's one way to see what has data. I'm gonna drop it right there and see what we got. So it looks like, gotta flip it around, maybe it's easier to see that when I did the transpose or swap rows and columns in Tableau. So I'm seeing a few different things. It looks like it did pull a good amount of data. All right, so let's do something with app downloads. Maybe the latest estimates. Android. We could do Android and iOS, but let's just do Android and keep the rest off of there. So I'm gonna undo that. Can do Control Z. Pop that out of there. Oh, maybe Control Y and keep the company. And we want app downloads, latest estimates, Android. And you can see it's originally by all the company's names. We can click descending sort to pull it in there. And now we know that only these have data. So I could filter those others out. So I'm actually going to click Control and drop a name onto filter, which is below there. And you could put condition by field. The latest estimate is greater than, let's just put one. So if you had one download, no bueno. All right, so there you go. So you have those, and that is a table. We should at least make it a graph there. So that's a bar chart. And again, with sort, you could do descending, see it like that. Let's call this Android app downloads estimated. So there you go. And those are the companies with that. So what is probably useful here for all of the companies listed of the comparison in a pie chart? Pie chart's super controversial, but you know, we could do them here. It's not too bad of a comparison. Or that, and again, we can do control, drag and drop name, drag and drop downloads, Change that to bold or something. Maybe a new font. Maybe a little bit bigger. That was huge, but there you go. And we can do a drop down on the label as well. Go to font and click match mark color. That's fine. Or you could just choose a different color entirely. And there you go. So you can also do edit colors since that's the default palette. Try never to use the default. Try to match the brands you're looking at. Try to match the different styles based on what it means. Is it positive or negative? Or is there some other palette that makes sense? Bring in your best design sense there to get it away from that palette and click OK. You can also lower the opacity and change it to have a border. That's a pretty rough color there, but it's just kind of getting a start on what we could graph. So let's do another graph as well. Let's take name again and put that on detail and maybe actually maybe in color. So those are all the companies that we've got. Trying to figure out what data we had before. We did have something with Twitter. Let me pull in the Twitter favorites, followers, and tweets and see what had some stuff there. Looks like we do have all of the data, and they do seem to be active on Twitter for the most part on these. So I only want two of those. So I'm gonna undo most of that, and I'm gonna do favorites on columns and followers on rows. So one thing in consulting that we love to do is 2x2 sort of matrices or relationships like this. So this is the relationship between two variables, and there's not a lot going on, but there is one outlier. So outliers do teach us a lot. Maybe they're just something that's weird and out there and not helpful, and sometimes they're doing something really right or really wrong, and we can learn a ton from them. So let's figure that out. We can hide the nulls that had zero on there. So these are the only companies that have data for Twitter. And we have this. So this is interesting. So the number of followers is here. So that has a 458,000 followers, and they have almost 19,000 favorites. So Alice Obscura is the outlier. That is a fun company. So of course it might be. So let's do Twitter favorites versus followers. Now, I'm thinking the number of followers could be the size of the thing. So on this one, I can drag and drop that onto size as well. So that'll really exaggerate that. Now that hollow circle is a little bit hard to follow. I can't quite see what is there. So I'm gonna put that as something else. You could use a plus. I think for followers should probably be something different. Maybe that's star, or if we made favorites the size, maybe we do that. Make favorites the size, and then you could do that as a plus, like a plus, you know, favorites plus check. I don't know, whatever. So we got that there, and you can see how that works. What else could we do? You could actually control click on that and put name onto the label. So you can see those right there and see Atlas Obscura as that lead one. Make it bold so you can see it a little better. Maybe make it a little bit different of a font. And maybe increase the size a little bit. Cool. All right. So that's one thing you could do. Also, I really love when you duplicate the chart. So as you're telling a story like TED Talk style, they actually have a lot of different slides that are variations of that one. So you can actually followers, I need a good spell check in this thing. Wow. Okay. So there we go. So we're going to right click on that and duplicate that sheet. So that other one is still here. This is a great idea. Even if you don't want to have multiple and you want to just experiment a little bit, go ahead and duplicate it so you don't mess up the original one. Pop over here. And what else can we do? I think we should right click on Atlas Obscura and maybe exclude it so that way we can look lower level and zoom in on that other area. So we know they're awesome. We talk about them here on the slide, have a cool presentation, click exclude, and then boom, we could see the relationship down here explode out because it all looked really tiny down there. It doesn't really tell you the difference between these. And now you can see that Oswego has a lot of followers and a medium amount of tweets that have favorites. And Next Retreat doesn't have that many followers, but has a lot of favorites. So something going on here with Next Retreat. So very cool. So you can even do in the analytics tab a trend line here and choose the different mathematical trend lines. I'm just choose a linear trend and see there. So it kind of gives us a reference so you can say, okay, this sort of has a relationship there. It's a little weak, but like that one's an outlier as far as number of followers, and this one's an outlier as far as the number of favorites. So just a few things to try out here. Explore the data, find whatever else you want in those other fields you can choose in the column filters on Deal Room and see what you can find out about the space that you want to strategically work in.
The digital data hero.